Hello ladies and gents, Nasha842 here, and welcome to Volume 2 of Resident Evil's Banned Footage DLC. Now, I have had a look at Ethan Must Die Mode, and I'm not going to bother playing through that because far too much of that hinges on luck for me to really enjoy it, and the same can be said for 21. Although I did give 21 a look at, I didn't like the fact that too much of that hinged on luck, and then there was some serious Yu-Gi-Oh! Heart of the Cards bullshit going on. And the AI would literally start beating me by like the exact card they needed, and then at the very end the AI cheats anyway, so I can't be arsed with that, so I'm not gonna bother. So I'm gonna skip straight to Daughters, the last of the episodes in the Banned Footage DLC, and by the looks of it, the most story driven one. So let's go.
Record-breaking rainfall from this week's hurricane looking to come to a close tomorrow morning as the storm moves on. Out in the Gulf, reports of a missing ship have rescue crews combing the coast. We'll have the details on that search shortly. But first, record rain over the past few days has left many residents in some of the parishes knee-deep in floodwaters. On radar, we can see the system moving along to the northeast, losing strength as it goes. And by tomorrow morning, we should be home.
Any news on the damage from the storm?
They haven't said.
Marguerite, open up. Down another.
I'm coming.
Oh. Oh, she's so young.
Yeah, how's our other guest?
Sleeping, poor thing.
Well, I say let him. He'll be okay here for a few days, leastwise till we can get him into town.
Zoe, go get some fresh clothes from the laundry room, okay? Oh, looks like there's some sort of oil spill or something.
Yes.
Let's get this poor girl some fresh clothes and into a warm bed. Mm. We'll put her in Lucas's old room.
Oh, come on, can't you put her somewhere else?
Oh, Lucas, you just hush. You've long outgrown that room. Always wanted to run a bed and breakfast.
Got your big break, didn't you? Get her to bed. I'll put some soup on. Ugh. Good night for soup, don't you think? Excuse me, Lucas. There's a change of clothes in the laundry room, dear.
It's just so surreal just seeing them as a normal family, actually. It's like after spending so long seeing them as all these fucked up people, it's... It's kind of strange just seeing them as like normal people. The windows are even like not boarded up. It's...
Zoe, she can't be in those dirty clothes all night.
Right, okay, gotta try and remember where to go now. The staircase is actually intact. Bathroom, wasn't it? Yeah, it was. That's the map. My recreation room is this one here.
Bunny, please get her cleaned up and into some dry clothes. I need to check on the boathouse. It was half underwater last I looked.
Yes, Daddy. All right, little girl. Let's get you cleaned up.
They're mine now.
What? Daddy? Is the power out?
Was there a lightning strike?
Okay. But clearly this is where shit hits the fan. Happened very quickly.
What was that?
Things seemed to fall apart very quickly after they found Evelyn, didn't it?
Lucas? What happened? Are you okay? What the hell's going on?
One very good lighter. Go and check the garage then. Well, that's opening slower than it did in the main game. So that rope's probably going to come into play a little bit later on then. So let's go back upstairs for the time being. Stairs are there.
I know. Mama, is that you?
Zoe, come look. Come see her gift. Look at all the pretties my little girl is giving me! Kiss me, lover!
What the hell? Get to the garage! Get some rope! Go, now!
Something I'll regret.
That happened very quickly. I thought that, Marguerite actually had the chance to go and visit the doctor before that started happening, but apparently not.
Cleanliness is next to godliness, and your mother's pretty fucking close to meeting him right now. She wants me to do this. I have to show her how to hold him. She wants us all to show her our love.
Daddy!
Well, you don't want to disappoint her now, do you? We can't do that.
What are you talking about?
Your new sister, Eve! When I ask for rope, I expect to get rope. I'm just gonna have to teach you a lesson.
Daddy, what's gotten into you?
While you're under my roof, you'll do as I say, you hear me.
Get away!
Well, okay, things deteriorated very quickly.
Please.
She's waiting for you.
Daddy,
okay.
No! Why are you doing this?
Now, what's the matter, honey? Don't you want to play with your new sister?
She is.
Okay, yes, I did fuck up there. Ran in the wrong direction.
When I ask for rope, I expect to get rope. I'm gonna just gonna have to teach you.
Okay, no, that's clearly not what you do.
She's waiting for you. Yo, what's the matter, honey? Don't you want to play with your new sister?
She
Right, okay, you can't run past him.
When I ask for rope, I expect to get rope. I'm gonna just
Daddy! What's gotten into you?
While you're under my roof, you'll do as I say, you hear me.
I gotta find a way out.
Zoe, open the door.
Get away!
You can't keep me out.
Stop it!
I'll up in our fucking closet.
Daddy.
Zoe! I ain't got time for this.
Yeah, shit fell apart very quickly.
See you, sugar.
Okay, so I wonder if I can just sprint to the door and... Apparently I'd run at like the speed of a snail or something. Okay, it's missing a dog head.
Get back here, you bad girl! Settle down! You don't want to have an accident, do ya? I'm gonna get ya!
Of course it's locked.
Zoe. Jack! Give me a hand here, Jack! Get over here, Jack! Daddy, stop! Why are you doing this?
Now what's the matter, honey? Don't you want to play with your new sister?
She is.
I gotta get out of here.
God, those erratic movements are really throwing me off. What?
Joey.
Okay, I'm not gonna complain about that. How has she not seen me yet? Don't get me wrong, I'm not complaining, but...
Zoe! You're gonna make me mad!
Sorry, I don't know what's wrong. Stay away! Don't touch her! Don't hurt my family!
I don't understand, Mama, what's going on?
Here! Take it! Take it! Go!
Don't worry, Mama. I'll go get help. Why is this happening?
Well now, there you are.
Jack! Get over here, Jack!
Okay. So was I supposed to run into their laundry room then?
Don't you want to play with your new sister?
She is.
Right, okay, so yeah, that was a car key. so if I try and run into the laundry room, that might,
Why is this happening?
Zoe!
I found you! No more running around. Zoe!
You always did like that.
Shut up! You ain't real!
Well, I've already fucked up multiple times, but at least I'm getting somewhere. What did that do? Oh, there we go.
Not you.
Is it supposed to be used as a weapon? No. Kind of curious as to what else you're supposed to use a broken glass bottle for.
Well, there you are.
Almost positive I'm missing something. So, am I supposed to bottle jack or something? So I've got to learn his route. Oh, fuck!
You are.
I was not expecting that.
I found you. No more running around.
I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing. I really should remember that that's not actually a safe room right now. That's just another room.
Not you.
Shit.
You're just being rude!
Okay, so that was a bad ending. But I do think we are gonna have another crack at that. Okay, then here we are at what I'd like to say is take two, but it's actually take three. yeah, I've cut out the second playthrough because I spent over an hour dicking around trying to find the... lead up to the true ending, which I just couldn't find at all. So I ended up having to look up a guide that was vague enough not to give spoilers on what exactly I should be doing. So I'm going to have another crack at that now and try and get the true ending this time around. Yes, I know I'm weak, but from what I read, the little things you've got to do to actually get the true ending are hidden quite out of the way. So... I'd like that I had no choice, but considering how long it took me to figure out the fork was the piece of the light puzzle for the snakehead in the bedroom DLC, I didn't really want to spend way too much of my time trying to figure that out too much. I haven't spoiled myself, it's just a vague little guide that sort of said, look at Lucas's phone before a certain moment's gone past, and that'll get you a... code that you use in the kid's bedroom, and then use a lockpick for an item that gets you an item that's used in the kid's bedroom, and so on. So I should be okay. Now, I'm not going to bother watching the intro FMV. You've already had a good preview of what's going on with the first playthrough I had, where I got the bad ending. So I just feel this time I'm okay just to commentate over everything. Of course, one of the advantages of recording is if I miss the password that Lucas puts into his phone, then I'm able just to watch the footage back. Poor
thing. Yeah, I say let him. He'll be okay here for a few days, leastwise till we can get him in a town.
Now I already know it's the true ending is involves getting to Mia, who's in the trailer, which is behind the dog head puzzle.
Poor girl, some fresh clothes and into a warm bed. Mm. We'll put her in Lucas's old room.
Oh, come on, can't you put her somewhere else?
Oh, Lucas, you just hush. You've long outgrown that room. Always wanted but a bed and breakfast.
You got your big break, didn't you? Get her to bed. I'll put some soup on. Ugh. Good night for soup, don't you think? Excuse me, Lucas.
Okay, that's 1019. Yeah, just want to make sure I've got that ready for when I need it. Okay, now first things first, we go and get the lockpick from down here now. And we don't use it on the drawer that's got the broken bottle in it. Because that serves absolutely no purpose whatsoever. Marguerite, yep, come right in the way.
Take that girl some clean clothes.
Okay then, just grab myself these so that I'm not wasting too much time running backwards and forwards. I'm actually trying out something a little bit new with my setup this time around, that I'm actually using a pair of headphones with the TV. So hopefully this should make my life a little bit easier. Okay, so that's where you use the lockpick. And that is what you've got to use in the bedroom you're about to go into, or I'm about to go into. Alright, that's the recreation room. I think this is it, isn't it? Yes, it is.
Honey, please get her cleaned up and into some dry clothes. I need to check on the boathouse. It was half underwater last I looked.
Yes, Daddy.
Right, okay, now the guide I used did say it was the small component that I got is used somewhere in here, so... Oh. Okay, then. One thing I'm not sure if I mentioned in the last game was there does seem to be a slight continuity error between this DLC and the main game. Since in the main game it was mentioned that Marguerite actually had Marguerite's descent into madness was a slow progress process even, as she had time to go to the doctor and get a scan, but that doesn't seem to happen here. So right, okay. I told you to keep your dirty hands off my laptop. Oh, you're just jealous of my hacker skills. This is what you get for using the same password for your phone and your computer, dipshit. Okay, so that's what that's for then. 1019.
Yes.
Also like how that's like the classic menu sounds from previous Resi games. The fuck you list, October 2014 edition. October 1st. The old man slapped me right in the face for checking my phone during dinner. Fuck you. 3rd of October. I can't say one word about Mama's cooking without getting yelled at. Fuck you. 5th of October. All I did was look in on Zoe when she was doing yoga and she calls me a pervert. Fuck you. 6th of October. The old man got drunk and started throwing all my crap in that red box out on the veranda. Fuck you. Okay. Right, so far it seems like the Baker family life most definitely wasn't perfect, but it was still somewhat tragic to... Well, somewhat tragic, it is tragic to see what they eventually became. But it seems like Lucas and his old man, Jack, have a few problems between them. Okay, now here we go. This is where things get started.
All right, little girl, let's get you cleaned up.
They're mine now.
What?
Okay, then. So, I've got a rough idea of what I've got to do now.
Daddy?
The veranda, that's not... thing outside, isn't it? It's like that balcony sort of thing. I have to go and have a thorough look around there when Jack starts chasing me. Or even when I escape Jack, even.
Where'd that little girl get to? What was that? Lucas? What happened? Are you okay?
Now to go and find Marguerite.
What the hell's going on?
Now I can't help but find some of the interactions between Marguerite and Jack somewhat humorous during this bit. I know I shouldn't do.
Zoe, come look. Come see her gift. Look at all the pretties my little girl has given me! Kiss me, lover!
What the hell? Get to the garage! Get some rope! Go, now!
Oh, get out of my way, Jack!
I'll regret.
I'm on my way, Daddy.
Looks. Cleanliness is next to godliness, and my mom is a good fucking close to meeting him right now.
You know, I know I probably shouldn't be finding that funny, but...
She wants me to do this.
I just do.
I have to show her how to hold her.
I mean, I don't think it's the way it's delivered, because, like, the voice actors in this game have done a pretty good job of making their characters believable.
I can't do that.
What are you talking about?
Your new sister, Eve!
All right, now what we do, we completely ignore everything that Jack's saying.
Daddy, what's gotten into you?
While you're under my roof, you'll do as I tell you.
There we go. Now the fork is over here.
Zoe, open this door.
Get away! Stop it!
Alright, and there we go. Now, Lucas's little rant on his computer makes me think that the next thing I've got to do is somewhere out here, because this is the only place outside you have access to before getting out to the trailer. Is that it? Ah, there we go. God, that's pretty well hidden, that. Probably because they don't make it like the other places where you just walk up and it'll go straight into the animation where it'll walk you through it. You've got to like really get into it. There you go, it's a whole lot easier to get out of there than it is to get in. Sounds absolutely horrible, that does.
I gotta get out of here.
Right. Despite the fact I spent over... Oh God. Despite the fact I spent over an hour trying to figure out what to do last time, I'm still not quite used to her roots yet, so her erratic movements kind of fucked me up a little bit. And that's the update installed. Lovely. There we go.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what's wrong.
Mama. Stay away. Don't touch her. Don't hurt my family.
I don't understand, Mama. What's going on?
Here. Take it. Take it. Go.
You know, it seems like Marguerite was actually the strongest of the lot. Or at least out of herself and Jack. She actually was able to resist a little bit just in this scenario when Jack apparently wasn't. Right, okay then. This is obviously the best lighter ever. It's got amazing sort of illumination, and it can survive out in the rain. Anyway, this is where Mia is. I did read the thing that pointed me in this direction in-game yesterday. I just didn't know how to get here before I looked it up. Just for clarification's sake. Right, okay. There's Mia, all unconscious and shit. Right, to the Baker family. Thank you for saving my life, but please forget all about me. I was assigned to transport some important cargo on that ship. Getting involved with me or that cargo can only cause trouble for your family. Big trouble. Please don't contact the police or state authorities. Just pretend we never met. And you saved me, so take this advice in return. If you see a girl near the ship who looks about 10 years old, do not approach her. If she talks to you, get away as quickly as you can. Just try not to make her angry in the process. If you've been feeling ill at all, then I'm afraid the worst may have already happened. It's a fate worse than death, and it can't be cured at a hospital. I'm so sorry. There is a way to stop it, though. Serum. If you inject, stop the sim. Okay. So the text is difficult to make out. Let me pick this up. There's all kinds of fucking detail, though. Give him that.
Sister.
Oh my god. Much scare. What?
I think I fell asleep.
Well, well, now, look who has decided to join us.
Wake up and smell the shitty coffee, Zoe.
Lucas.
You okay, dear? There was a lot of excitement from that storm last night.
I'm fine. I had the weirdest dream last night. There was this little girl.
Well, now, after breakfast, Lucas and I are going to have a look around and see if the storm did any damage. You two should have a look around the house.
That's a good idea, Jack. You remember the last hurricane? We thought we were lucky. And the next time it rained, there was a mess for sure.
Hello, sister.
What? Now Zoe's mundane life has become a struggle for survival. She will spend her days slipping through the grasp of her now insane family, searching for the serum that Mia spoke of in her letter. The nights are marked by the family's murderous feasts, and Eveline's body deteriorates as the months go by. Eventually Zoe will encounter Ethan, her best hope of finding the serum, but she has a long way to go before that day. And so began the horror. So I don't get it now. Was Zoe the first of the Baker family to actually be infected? And then the others sort of followed? Perhaps that's how Zoe was able to tell that something was off about Evie before the rest of the Baker family were. I don't know, perhaps not. I wonder if that's going to be expanded upon at all. I wonder if they're going to do a little bit more with Zoe's struggle for survival before Ethan turned up. It'd be something interesting to see, I do think. Anyway, as far as that goes, it was a little bit faster than I was expecting it to be, but then again, I did have some help, so I suppose I can't really complain too much, because I knew roughly where to look for puzzle pieces to progress, so that would shorten the time a little bit. But for now, I do think I'm done until the Not a Hero expansion releases in the spring.